guys, welcome to Snowbreak Containment Zone, and courtesy of Snowbreak GG, and especially to Vikash, we do have this preview. So Vikash, thank you very much for translating this, and let's go over the details of the skill of Marian-Riptide. So we do have here a couple of animations that she has. Hopefully we can have more information on her skills tomorrow, as we can get her for free. That's it, guys. She's available for free. Okay, so we have her standard skill, C's Skirmish. So this one is similar to Fenny Starshine, in which she provides herself with a special ammo, which is in a Kraken magazine, and produces Beastly Roar bullets and deals skill damage. So special bullets which deal skill damage. Again, similar to Fenny Starshine, Marian's rate of fire is increased while firing Beastly Roar bullets, and they are consumed first versus standard ammo. This skill can be recast to discard the Kraken magazine early. Okay, take note of that. So we do have two neuronics for this skill. So when you have a chaos weapon increased, Marian's standard skill is damage is boosted based on the amount of Beastly Roar bullets that were loaded into her Kraken magazine. Reloading the Kraken magazine will update the strength of the buff based on the new amount. Again, there are no values here, so we'll have to find that out tomorrow. So when a chaos weapon is equipped, and Marian doesn't have a Kraken magazine equipped, the cooldown of her standard skill is reduced for each projectile hit when shooting. So this kinda regenerates her, you know, her, the energy for the standard skill. Probably this is more of reduced cooldown. Not sure, we'll have to wait for tomorrow. So most importantly, let us discuss her support skill. This is why we are here, and this is the animation for her support skill. So evidently she is able to take any active operative off the field, and she replaces them. But let's go over the details of this skill. So after this support skill is cast, Marian will remain on the field and will not automatically switch out. Based on my understanding, the active operative, or Katya Dawnwing, is going to have to accumulate at a certain level something that will trigger Marian to come in. So the passive for this skill, whenever a squad member casts their standard skill, Marian gains stacks of melody. Additionally, Marian gains stacks of melody for each second while the squad is in combat, but Marian is not active. So while the active operative, or Katya Dawnwing to be specific, is on the field, Marian gains melody. So Marian cannot gain melody while she has Kraken magazine equipped. Take note of that. So once a specific threshold has been reached, Marian switches in to become the active operative and reloads additional Beastly Roar bullets into her Kraken magazine based on the amount of melody stacks that she has, consuming all stacks in the process. From what I believe is, she stores melody, reaches a certain threshold, comes in, shoots her way out, then once the previous operative or Katya Dawnwing is ready to go, you can actually swap her inside. So it's basically a swapping mechanism between two operatives. So shoot with the primary, then support skill, then wait for the threshold. Marian comes in, shoots again. Then when she's done, you can switch again to the previous operative before. So it's a switching mechanism for the support skill. So neuronic, when the squad member hits an enemy with a shot, Marian receives extra melody stacks. Disability number two is disability can be cast while affected by control effects, also cleansing control effects from Marian. So that is the first thing that she gives for the active operative. Her ultimate skill is throwing a grenade up top. So as we go through the ultimate, Ultimate is named Marine Magma. So it has a passive. So all squad members are buffed with Color Wave effect, allowing for skill damage to ignore a portion of enemy elemental resistances. So this is going to be additional elemental resistance for the active operative that is actually this is for the whole squad. So this includes Marian as well. So ignore a certain portion, we don't know how much. If you use Katya Dawnwing, she has ignore elemental resistance as well on her M3. So this is going to, I think, be compounded with each other because they're two different operatives. So active, Marian throws out a time bomb, creating multiple explosions that deal chaos damage. The range of the bomb increases with each explosion. So number one, neuronic, is the damage dealt by explosions increase over time, and the final damage explosion stuns hit enemies. Okay, for the passive, Devo's passive, Convergent Evolution, when equipped with a Chaos Weapon, increases standard skill damage dealt by all squad members. So this includes a buff scaling with alignment index. So this one, basically, she helps the active operative in three ways. So you have her passive, next you have her ultimate, and the other one, you have her support skill. So three ways. Plus, I'm assuming her weapon will also help in that department as well. So we'll have to wait for that. So again, in this is theoretical. We're going to be going through the actual practice tomorrow. Once we get her and once we have her as a free unit, I will probably stream tomorrow and check out how she does. Marian actually drops at 10 a.m. UTC plus 8. So there is a big chance I'll be streaming how her synergy will be good, not only with Katya Dawnwing, but with other operatives. So, guys, thank you very much for staying this far. Comment down below what you think. Take care. Stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.